This presentation shares methodological and case study findings from an ongoing study of graduate research contributions to change processes. University-based research has a major role to play in addressing societal challenges, as students constitute the current and next generation of researchers, practitioners, and decision makers. Pressure is growing for higher education institutions to deliver and demonstrate impact. The shift towards transdisciplinarity requires new ways of assessing research impact, which has led to the emergence of new research evaluation methods. Graduate research presents a unique opportunity to learn about and improve transdisciplinary research impact. By understanding how graduate research projects make contributions to outcomes and where they fall short, we can inform how higher education institutions can better support more impactful research. Three projects were selected for their potential to contribute to real-world impact. They were done as part of an interdisciplinary doctoral program at Royal Roads University. The student researchers were all mid-career development practitioners, each tackling a different development issue in Africa, including post-conflict transitional justice in Uganda, private aid in Tanzania, and water sanitation and hygiene in Nigeria. We used the principles and criteria presented in the Transdisciplinary Research Quality Assessment Framework, hereafter referred to as the QAF, as a checklist of project elements that, in theory, should help project activities and outputs to be relevant, credible, legitimate, and effective. We scored each criterion to determine which elements of transdisciplinary research design and implementation were or were not present in the projects. When QAF results were paired with a theory-based outcome evaluation, we were able to draw connections between what projects did and what outcomes were realized. These diagrams present the project's QAF scores. Each will be explained in more detail. The main takeaway is that the projects had varying transdisciplinary characteristics, but there were strong elements common to all. The scoring highlighted discrepancies between projects' design and implementation that help explain differences in outcomes. Under relevance, each project identified and addressed a socially relevant problem identified through each student's professional experience. Only one of the three projects had a fully developed theory of change, with planned activities for meaningful outcomes for its stakeholders through a co-generated and co-owned research process. In contrast, the other projects had less well-developed ideas about how the research would influence change, which did not enable strategic planning or adaptive management. Credibility had the greatest variation in scores, which was surprising as we would expect elements of scientific rigor to be the foundation of any research project. As a common strength, all projects had adequate competencies represented within the research team, such as in their use of methods, support for local languages, and interpersonal and intercultural skills. However, satisfaction of the criterion on limitations varied across the cases. Projects that scored lower did not explain the implications of project limitations on the findings. Under legitimacy, all projects were assessed to be ethical, as sensitive topics required careful engagement with participants and confidentiality. For example, the truth-telling project's post-conflict context and involvement of young people required extra caution to do no harm. The extent of genuine and explicit inclusion was another distinguishing quality between projects. This aspect was strong in the truth-telling project because it was developed in partnership with participants and local organizations. Under effectiveness, all projects supported capacity building to different degrees. The truth-telling project empowered young people with communication and social skills, equipped partner organizations, and built new research skills across the team. The sanitation project supported the students' professional development, but missed the opportunity to integrate capacity building for other system actors into the project. Most outputs from each project had practical application and were well positioned to stimulate action. Both the truth-telling and private aid projects uncovered and filled relevant practice gaps for future truth-telling commissions and development practice, respectively. Some informants suggested the sanitation project would have been more effective had it developed context-appropriate sanitation solutions as part of the findings. These cases demonstrate that graduate research can contribute to diverse change processes in research, organizational practice, governmental policy, and professional development. We found that projects with stronger transdisciplinary elements had more pronounced outcomes. This suggests researchers seeking to make a difference should take the necessary time to fully understand the social problem and its context, identify key actors and processes to engage, and strategically design research to be more useful and used. Developing an explicit and detailed theory of change has proven to be a key ingredient of impactful research. The QAF is a useful guide to systematically think through the planning and implementation of transdisciplinary projects. QAF results also uncover transdisciplinary qualities supported by training, as well as those which were inherent in the student researchers. The students built interdisciplinary research skills through the DSOC-SCI program, complemented by their prior experience, propensity for self-reflection, creativity, resourcefulness, and trust-building skills. Students were also personally and professionally motivated to influence positive change through their research. To cultivate impactful research, universities should recruit students who are interested in change-making and provide appropriate training in epistemology, methodology, and stakeholder engagement. Training and support in the use of theory of change are also critical. To help foster an impact culture, universities should undertake systematic impact assessments of their research portfolios to ensure continuous learning from successful research endeavors as well as failures. Finally, through our testing and scoring of case studies, we identified several aspects of the quaff that could be improved, including adding criteria, clarifying definitions, avoiding double counting, and replacing the rubric statement with practical guidance to increase the utility of the quaff for planning, as well as ex ante and ex post evaluation. We expand on this learning further in another conference contribution. More information about the methods and case study findings can be found in the following articles.